Some storms come in and it was stronger than others, but it's still not a storm that Jesus cannot stop, because he is a storm stopper.
Oh yes.
And while the boat was rocking, while the lightning was flashing and the thunder was roaring, and when waves was clashing in the boat, the Bible says so much water had got in the boat that the boat had got full and it was getting ready to sink. Sometimes God will let your boat get full before he step in and do anything. Then he says, God, oh, you think you're about to get ready to die? Oh, yes, you do. He said, God is too full. The Bible said that the boat was sinking. Jesus was in the back, sleeping on the pillow.
Yes.
He was tired from preaching all day. Then he even says, God, and the water was that was coming, and the disciples were steady getting buckets in. It's so much going on that you don't forget that Jesus is on your boat. Sometimes you can be going through something and going through so many storms that you forget, hold up, Jesus is on the boat. But the Bible said that the boat became full of water.
Oh, yes.
Sometimes you say, God, I'm full with problems and full with financial difficulties and full of enemies, full of lies that people have told on me. Full of how many people don't betray me. And God, it seemed like I'm getting ready to sink. And God, if one more thing happened, my boat gonna get ready to go down. But while they were throwing water after boat, one of the apostles said, hold up, Jesus is on the boat. And they turned around to Jesus. And since God hasn't come, I told you that we're going through a storm, we got to learn how to call on Jesus. Is behind you when a storm is in front of you.
My God.
Because the Bible said he was in the hinder part of the ship. He was behind him. When God tells you to go, Master, do you care that we perish? You ain't going to talk to me today.
Come on,
sir. And a whole lot of us, we ain't going to tell you, but sometimes you really feel like, God, do you even care?
Come on now.
I know I'm not going to get no amens.
Amen.
Because we got to seem super spiritual in front of our brothers and our sisters.
Come on.
But can I give you pastor testimony? It's been time I said, God, it seems like you don't even care. And where you at? And why did you tell me to go? I don't even want to do it anymore. Do you even say, God, you can send somebody else. You got to use me anyway. We can use anybody to preach. Come on, say, God. Look at Job. Job at first said, the Lord give it, the Lord take it away. He was all right at first. They took his possessions. He was all right. The Lord give it, the Lord take away. The devil come back and gave us a whole storm, took his children, took all his children. Job said, curse be the day that I was born. See, you're getting there now.
Uh-huh.
Curse be the day I was born. I wish I never would have seen daylight. And God, where are you? See, you ain't gonna be truthful, but I'm gonna show you what you're telling God in private, what you're saying in your heart.
Come on,
and God, you don't even care nothing about me. God, is you really real? Now, a few months ago, you was in the house of God shouting, saying, God is real.
Come on now.
But now you say, God, where are you? And God, is you real? And you so powerful, how come you want to deal with this situation? And if you so powerful, how come you don't stop me from all the stuff that's lying on me? And if you so powerful, how come you don't deal with that crazy supervisor? Come on, say to God, the finances ain't came in yet.
Come on, sir.
And you said, maybe the preacher hit it wrong when he told me that God was Jehovah Jireh. And you start down with Jehovah Jireh, your provider. Your body start feeling a little bit of pain. You said maybe the preacher was wrong when he said that God was Jehovah Rapha. He even says, God, but now that the preacher was wrong, that God be true, that every man be a liar. Do you even say, God, because God is still a healer, Ask Livia over there yesterday, chest was hurting. And I prayed for her, and God healed her right outside.
Yes.
God healed her so quick she forgot she was healed. I said, well, God heal you now, tell us. She sat right there for so long. I asked her around about an hour later. I said, how your chest feeling? She said, oh, I forgot it stopped. Do you assess God? Because God is Jehovah Rapha. God is still a healer. God is still a deliverer. God is still a restorer. God is still reviving. God is still turning. God is still saved. God is still redeemed. God is still deliverer.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Lord, do you care that we perish? Do you care that I'm perishing? Do you care about what I'm going through right now? We don't tell anybody, but if you don't say it out your mouth, you don't say it in your heart. I don't even believe God is for real. And you've seen healings and miracles right in your midst. But the enemy will come and snatch everything you saw.
Yes.
And make you doubt God. And then you'll have some critics, the multitude will come up. And they'll start playing stuff in your spirit. And before you know it, you backslide outside of God's house. Because backsliding starts gradually. Little by little, 1 minute you're on the front row, the second row, the third row, you're on the third row. Next thing you know, you're all the way back in the back. You know what? You're ready to leave outside of the house of God. Because it's something that you're going through. You're going through a storm. You say this storm been going on for 2 years. And you say, I don't know what God is at. You say, I don't see no light. You say, I don't see nothing but darkness. You say, winds are blowing. You say, I don't see the rain crashing in my boat. You say, I don't see the Son of God. But God said, I want you to get ready to. Then we perish. They say we perishing and you sleep. We perishing and you ain't doing nothing. How come God seems like when you go through something, he don't do nothing?
My God.
God, where are you? You ain't said nothing. You ain't did nothing. God, where are you? Master, do you care? Some of us are asking God, God, do you care? Do you care about my plight? Master, carest thou that we perish? And when they called on Jesus, the Bible said Jesus got up in the waves. Do you hear the saints of God? Oh, he was down there in the boat sleep because he was all man and he was all God. He was all man and he had sleep. But he was all God when he got up in the boat. When the enemy arose, arise, call on God, because Jesus arose. All you have to do is call on and wait on him, saying, God, the Bible said he arose.
Yes, yes, Lord.
Watch the sleep out of his eye. They said, wake up. They said, don't you see all this? You see the lightning flashing, the thunder's roaring. Do you see the water in the boat? They said, do something, we're panicking. Because when we're going through storms, we begin to panic. Even with Jesus on the boat, you're still panicking. Jesus right there on the boat, but you're still panicking.
Yeah.
God, we need ready to perish. But they said, watch us sleep out your eyes. Jesus looked up and rebuked the winds and walked to the end of the boat and told the sea, shut up. Turned away and walked back in the sea said, shh. The wind said, shh.
Yeah.
And when he said, peace be still, the wind said, silence, and stay silent.
Yeah.
Then he says, yeah, I told you that there is a time and a season for Jesus to tell your story, shut your mouth. Then he says, you don't have to shut your enemy's mouth.
Uh-uh.
A time is coming when God will shut their mouth. God will make their tongue stick to the roof of their mouth.
Come on,
they don't even open their mouth from against you, and they don't even know why. Because he said, listen, I knew the storm was coming. There was a cut-off point to your storm. And since God, this is the reason why I want you to rejoice, because there was a cut-off point. The storm don't last forever. There was a time and season when Jesus said, shut up. Then supervisor, Jesus tell him in the midnight hour, he have a dream about you. Have a dream about the same person he was studying missing with. And have a dream about you. And God tell the supervisor, leave them alone. In his spirit, he don't leave you alone.
Oh, yeah.
He come to work the next day and see you. How you doing? You're like, what's wrong with this man? This man always talking crazy and coming to me sideways, but today he said, how you doing? And I want you to come into the office because I want to talk to you about giving you a raise. You've been a good worker. You know why? Because now the storm is over. Uh-huh. Do you ever say, God? And now there's something else on the other side. Now your increase has come. Do you ever say, God? But all you got to know how to do is to make it to the other side. You got to be able to go through. Blessings on the other side. Breakthrough is on the other side. Turnaround is on the other side. Rejoicing is on the other side. But you gotta be able to have peace in the midst of the storm. While you go through, God will speak to your enemies.
Oh yeah.
I had a supervisor one time, and he used to get very irritated because when he come and start talking crazy, I would pull off from him. And he come cussing, I would pull off from him. And he used to have to come and find me. Ellis, come here, come here. This is what I'll ask you to do, because I don't have to cuss you out. I'm just going to walk away from it like you ain't saying nothing. You're going to be the one that's feeling stupid. Do you understand, God? But this man, I was every day, he would get irritated. Sometimes the anointing of God is on you is irritating the demon inside of them. Do you understand, God? And this man would talk crazy almost every day. But God told me, hold your peace. Let him cuss you out, but hold your peace. Hold those saints of God. I wasn't used to that. You ain't gonna cuss me away and get away with it. You ain't gonna call me no D and no H and all that and get away with it. You ain't gonna be talking crazy to me. You don't go ahead and get this over right now. It's been so many times. I say, God, I say when break time come, I'll be waiting out there with my shirt off, right behind the door. I'm talking about why serve God. I said, when you get out there, I'm gonna tell him this and all, brother, take your shirt off and come on, we can get this over right now. You even say, God, but all those time that's in the heart, God said, don't you do that. You're going to ruin your testimony. I'm not a man to beat that boy down. Do you hear me say, God? I know who ain't going to talk to me. But God had me going through a storm. And God was trying to teach me something. God said, I want to deal with your anger.
Come on.
I want to deal with your violent tendencies. God said, I want to deal with that filthy mouth. And God said, the way I'm going to deal with it, I'm going to pray about you by taking you through a storm. Do you hear me say, God? This went on for years. My wife, no, I'm not lying. Not just him, but other people also. This went on for years. I said, years. One day he came to work. He said, Ellis, come here. And I wasn't finna keep on drive. I thought he was gonna say something dumb. And he said, Ellis, come here. And I came to him. He said, what church are you in? I said, what you mean, what church you're in? He said, I had a dream about you last night. And he said, in the dream, he said, you had on your work clothes, your uniform. He said, but you was looking up to the sky. And he said, when you look up to the sky, he said, I heard you in a dream saying, God, what did you want me to do? He didn't know what the dream meant, so he said, man, you need to get back in church. Didn't even say, God. But since that day forward, I had no problems with being able to church, God, because God know how to stop your storm. Just give it a little while longer. Do you hear me? Say, God, keep on loving on him. Keep on going just a little bit farther. Come on, just a little bit higher. Do you hear me? Say, God, God's not going to give you peace.
Oh, yes.
Some of your spouses shouldn't get ready to do that. Because every time they cuss at you, they can't even feel comfortable.
Oh, my God.
They come back telling you they saw. You know why? Because God said, the king's heart is in the hand of the Lord. And like the rivers of water, I turn their heart whichever way I want to. God said, I'll turn their heart, and they won't know how come they're going to leave. Sister Ellis, can't leave Pastor Ellis.
Pastor Ellis, can you
speak? I'm putting proud. Do you hear me say to God? The king's heart is in the hand of God. Yes, Lord. But Jesus said, peace, be still. Get ready. Some of you that have been going through a storm, Jesus will get ready to say, the storm is over. You have passed the test. You stayed faithful to me these couple of years. This storm has been a long time. But Jesus is getting ready to turn the tide. He said he spoke to the winds. Then he spoke to the sea. Said, peace, be still. And there was a great calm. There was a great calm. Some of you get ready for a great calm. It's going to be so quiet in your house, you're going to say, hold on now, you're going to start getting kind of scared. I'm used to hearing noise. I'm used to somebody throwing pots and pans and cussing. It's too quiet up in here. But Jesus said, peace be still.
Peace be still.
The storm is over.
Mm-hmm.
Because Jesus, the storm stopper,
oh, yeah,
said the season is over.
Yeah.
And he said, while we're trying to teach you, I was trying to teach you to have peace in the midst of the storm.
Yes.
And after the storm ceased, the Bible says something. Screams that the apostles said one to another. They said, what manner of man is this? That even the sea and the winds obey him. Jesus was trying to give them another revelation of who he was when it was going through the storm. And since God, sometimes when you go through the storm and you go through trials and tribulation, sometimes the only thing that Jesus is trying to do, he's trying to give you a different revelation of who he is.
Yes.
And now not only do they know that Jesus had the authority to cast out devils, or to heal the leper, or heal blind by the mass, but now they knew Jesus had the power over the storm.
Oh, yes.
And saints of God, I came to tell you today, I don't know what storm you're going through right now. It may be an outer storm that everybody see, or it may be an inner storm that you're feeling down inside your spirit. And you say, man of God, I've been having this storm down inside my spirit for many years. You say, I have not been able to rest. You say, it seems like it's been a tornado or a hurricane moving around inside my spirit. You say, I can't get along with nobody and don't even know why. You say, I can't lay down and rest at night unless I pop some pills, unless I have some sex, unless I'm drinking. Do you even say, yeah? You say, I don't know any peace, but Jesus.
Oh, yes.
Is the Prince of Peace.
The Prince of Peace.
He said, I've come to stop your storm.
Oh, yes.
When you call on Jesus. Oh, my God. The devil won't try to stop you from calling on Allah. He won't try to stop you from calling on Confucius.